How we doing, everybody? Right, bit of a roll at the moment with these lovely condition techniques coming in. I've never seen this before. There's so many turntables coming through my door, which are being worked on, that are in absolutely beautiful condition. And it makes a nice change in comparison to some of the ones that you see all the time where I'm stripping them down, having to rebuild them and, you know, wrap them, etc. This one is gorgeous. There's the odd scratch at the top where you can see the dust covers at some point have obviously taken a bit of a scratch at the back. But that aside, what a lovely, lovely Mark II this is. So this is coming to me from my customer, Peter. It was just coming for a service. There was a few parts that were given to me to put on. So we've popped on a brand new, genuine Panasonic RCA cable. I popped on one of my custom ground cables because, as you'll probably all know by now, if you are buying genuine grounding cables from eBay or anywhere online, they tend to be a lot shorter than the original RCA cables. And that was not the case when these were new. Grounding cables were always the same length pretty much as the original RCAs. So I've made a grounding cables particularly just to go with this brand new audio cable. So that's been done. The original pitch trim, original everything on here. Absolutely beautiful. The arm section, I say original everything, the arm section itself, the supports for the arm and the bearings top and bottom on the original arm were damaged. Now, I was going to replace the bearings on the original, but the customer actually contacted me. He managed to track down a very, very nice condition central section with the bearings in beautiful working order. And, well, yeah, I can confirm that they are. So he posted it down to me. I've installed that. I've polished up the pivots. The bearings are lovely. Arm's been rebuilt from scratch. And we're back in business again. Plenty of machine polished parts on here. So the sockets themselves are machine polished. Platter has been machine polished. Pitch unit. Oh man, the pitch is lovely on this. Absolutely lovely. Bit of a background on this turntable. From what my customer told me, this was only ever used for hi-fi use. And I actually do believe him, if I'm honest. From when he bought this from the gentleman he purchased this from, I think it was part of a stack system. The arm at some point, because of the bearings being damaged, it looks like it had been replaced at some point, or parts of the arm had been replaced because a couple of screws internally were incorrect. So somebody actually had a crack at removing the arm. The soldering wasn't the best. That aside though, now this is done correctly. This is a beautiful turntable. We've replaced the pop-up with an SMD warm white pop-up. I'm not going to show you that. There's absolutely no point me showing you. You've seen it a million times before. Everything on this deck is standard. Okay, so the LEDs are standard, speed selection switches, etc. But apart from the odd mark on this deck, this is a lovely turntable. And it's cleaned up exceptionally well. It's got the original rubber mat, as you can see, if I can spit my words out. The original rubber mat. Even the pitch trim's original. The only thing I've changed on this is obviously the shader cloth underneath, as I did have a bit of dirt underneath and it was coming unstuck. So I've replaced the shader cloth felt underneath the plinth itself. But all in all, a very nice turntable. Even kept the cloth that the customer supplied me for the 45 adapter. I'll pop that back into place. No, that is not the original, guys, before anyone says to me, oh, what have you done that for? That's how he supplied it to me. That's how it's going back. And everything underneath has been cleaned. But the platter on this, look at this, guys. Oh, yes, you can see me top of my head and my camera look in the reflection. So all in all, a very nice condition turntable. It's been serviced. Like I say, audio cable replaced. Custom grounding cable installed. Tone arm section for the assembly has been replaced with the bearings all factory, all in lovely condition. Good cleanup, board service. There are a few dry joints on this board that needed some attention and a couple of components that obviously required replacing as part of a service. But all in all, we're back rocking again. I think this is going to be used purely just as a hi-fi turntable again. And I think he's done exceptionally well to find one in this condition, and it's going to give him years and years of, you know, of fun. It's another way really of putting it. And there we go. So I thought I'd just show you that one there, this turntable. There's a few more to show you which are going to be up very shortly on video. We've got a pair of green camouflage turntables, which are lovely. I wasn't a massive fan of the green wrap at first until I sort of sat back and thought, yeah, I like it. So you're going to see that shortly. And also the carbon fiber turntables that I'm in the middle of completing as well. So I'm hoping to have them all up at the end of the week. For those of you that are still waiting for replies back to comments, I do apologize. Exceptionally busy at the moment. Lots of things going on. I will get back to you as soon as I can. There is still a lot of email responses to go through at the moment, as well as the usual WhatsApp, Facebook, and just social media in general. Has been an absolute nightmare. People asking me a million technical questions and things, and oh, I love it. But yeah, give me a break, guys. Please try and give me a break. So there we go. That's the standard of a deck that's come in lovely condition, serviced, ready to rock and roll. And I thought I'd show you. So keep your eyes peeled on the page, guys, because there's lots more to come up. Thanks very much for watching. I'll speak to you all soon.